In another video, I've shown the simple connection procedure between the FE170 frontends and the base units, and the excellent signal performance of a 2 GHz wide signal transmitted in D-band. For some applications in this frequency range, even wider bandwidths might be required. And therefore, I would like to show another innovative feature on the signal generator. With the bandwidth extension option, the SMW has the capability to extend the RF modulation bandwidth by using the two internal basebands. With such an approach, signals with up to 4 GHz of instantaneous RF modulation bandwidth can be generated out of a dual pass SMW. Now let's have a closer look on the instrument. The two baseband signals are output at the two RF connectors and then combined by using an RF combiner. In this demo, the IF signal is used for the connection to the FE170ST, but of course, this feature can also be used without a frontend. The mode can be enabled in the system configuration menu, which is shown here. Before starting measurement, an initial alignment procedure is required, which is fully automated by the push of a button. The alignment is already done, so we can close this. And coming now to the baseband block, we can see that the sampling rate has been increased to support now waveforms with up to 4.8 GHz of sampling rate. In this demo, we use a single carrier waveform file with 4 GHz of RF modulation bandwidth. The icon here shows that the FE170 is connected and we transmit the signal at 148 GHz. For the transmission, we use horn antennas and a short over-the-air distance to the receiver, which is the FE170SR. The front end is connected to the FSW signal and spectrum analyzer. This unit can be equipped with up to 8.3 GHz of analysis bandwidth. In this case, the instrument is equipped with a B4001 option, which offers up to 4.4 GHz. Now let's have a closer look on the analysis side. On the analyzer, we can see the spectrum of the 4 GHz wide signal transmitted at 148 GHz. To demonstrate that it's a live signal, I can also interrupt the signal. For the analysis of the signal quality, we can go to the VSA mode, and here we see the constellation diagram of the 16 QAM modulation with a symbol rate of 4 GHz and the excellent signal quality shown by the VM result. To unlock the potential of sub-terahertz and terahertz frequency regions, high-performance measurement equipment is required. With the shown new features, Rohde and Schwarz supports early 6G research activities for these applications.